Alright, Shalom. First, I want to give all praises, glory and honor to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone, that rule well, that taught us his truth, blessings to the elect, the nation of Israel, and all those who are scattered worldwide who are predestined to be saved. This is Brother Yakel, coming with a short lesson, and Lord willing, it will be edifying. Alright, today's lesson is basically one of the brothers in Great Millstone, I watched a lesson that he did earlier on, and it was very powerful and made a lot of sense on a spiritual level. And this truth is spiritual, okay? And the one thing we have to understand is that the coming economic collapse, the coming Great Tribulation, or Jacob's Trouble, it's called in Jeremiah 13:7. What we brothers and a few sisters that in his truth have to understand, that judgment is not for us, okay? The tanks, the military, you know, the guns, the concentration camps, you know, the MLTB in particular, all of that is not for us, all right? It's for our enemies, and our enemies are our people who are blinded to his truth, all right, and the other nations, okay? And I'll open it up with a scripture, because the Lord said that he's going to sift the house of Israel, all right? And in this time coming up, all the death and destruction, and let's be honest about it, when this happens, you know, it doesn't matter how long you've been in this truth, this is going to be a time that no one has ever seen before, all right? A time not experienced on this earth, okay? Let's get that to open up this lesson, all right? So it's something that is going to be so devastating. And it's not going to be easy seeing your people getting off the record numbers, you know? Oh, what is happening over there in our homeland is going to be worse than that. All right. This is Matthew 24:21. All right. For then shall be great tribulation, such as not since the beginning of this world to this time, no, nor ever shall be. All right. So this great tribulation is not going to be any, it's going to be something that is not ever happened on this earth. That's how bad it's gonna get. All right, verse 22. And except those days be shortened, all right, there shall no flesh be saved. See, so that's a metaphor. The Lord is telling you, unless the Lord has to speed up the time, because what's coming is gonna be so bad. All right, there's gonna be so much killing. There'll be no one left. All right, and that goes into in the book of Ezra as well. We'll get that scripture next. All right. And it concludes, but for the elect's sake, those days shall be shortened. So everything starts with the elect and nation Israel. That's why, you know, when I opened up, obviously, you know, I said, you know, double honors to Apostle Elders Great Millstone. And I said, blessings to the elect, because it's all about them. All right. Those, the elect, the 144,000, and the rest of our people who are scattered worldwide, who the Lord has put it, he's made a judgment already that they're going to be saved. All right. Salvation is for them. The rest of our people, all right, this tribulation that's coming, all right, is basically their judgment. Okay. So the Lord is going to have to speed up the time. So that shows you how much killing is going to be on the planet Earth when this happens. All right. And it reminds me, because years ago I watched this film called Hacksaw Ridge, and it's based upon a true story. All right, amazing story, and it's an amazing story of faith. It's one of the best war movies, all right, you'll ever watch, and it's based upon a true story. And I believe, and even the apostles believe, that the main character, a man that lived, Desmond Doors, he looked like an Edomite, but he must have been an Israelite, man. All right? because he had great faith in the face of such evil and adversity. Okay, his story was so amazing that they made a film out of it. All right, and the way it relates to the subject is that there is going to be killing. There's going to be things that we ain't, you know, seen or experienced before. You know, and at first you might bug out and say, oh my gosh, this, that and the other, but we have to remember that this judgment is not for us. All right, this judgment is not for us. Okay, that's why if we go to look Amos chapter 9 verse 9, and it says, for lo, I will command and I will sift the house of Israel among all nations like corn is sifted in a sieve, yet shall not the least grain fall upon the earth. All right, verse 10, all the sinners of my people, all right, and who's the Lord's people? The 12 tribes of Israel shall die by the sword. And a modern day sword is a knife, a gun, a tank shell, all right, bloody, they've got guns where, you know, they've basically got guns that can give you heart attacks. The Lord has given Esau that technology. Alright, so all the sins of my people shall die by the sword, which say, the evil shall not overtake nor prevent us. Alright, so the ones, especially our people that are wacky, as Apostle Bar says, the wacky tacky Christians, they're going to, you know, be praying in the name of Jesus, and they're actually going to think that the Lord is going to be with them. Alright, and then they're just going to get put to death. Alright, and if you read that same scripture in the NLT, what does it say? All right, it says Amos 9:8. It says, but all the sinners, Amos 9:10, but all the sinners will die by the sword. All those who say nothing bad will happen to us. All right, so our people that are into Islam, Christianity, you know, or you worship the white man. I mean, basically, if you're a Christian, you worship, and you know, and you believe that the one you call Jesus Christ is the so-called white man, which he is. All right, he is a white man, Cesare Borgia. All right, who was the person that they depicted the white Jesus picture, you know, on? He was an Edomite. All right, so those people that are in the church and so forth, you know, who roll around on the floor and say they got the Holy Ghost on them, they're gonna be saying, nothing bad will happen to us. The blood of Jesus will cover us. And then they're going to get put to death. Okay? So that's why in this period of time, faith is going to kick in. But notice that all of these bad things that come on this earth, that's not for us. It says all the sinners of my people shall die by the sword. Alright? And who are the sinners? It's the ones of our people that are not predestined to be saved, which is the majority of our people. Alright, now this film is excellent, and I applaud everyone to try and watch this film, because it's based upon a true story, and it's absolutely amazing. So we watched the clip, but it shows you the kind of chaos. Just gives you a little example of the chaos that is going to happen, because remember, it's going to be the worst time ever on earth. The worst time, so it's going to be even worse than this, and this is based upon World War II. All right, so let's watch this clip.
What the hell is your delay, Captain?
We're waiting, sir.
Waiting for what?
Private Doss.
Who the hell is Private Doss?
And by the way, when they said, oh, he's waiting, all right, and he goes, waiting for what? And they said, Private Doss. And he goes, who's Private Doss? And when they said he was waiting, he prayed. All right, he was praying. All right, before he went on missions. All right, and before one of the last missions, he said, "Listen, you know, I have to go and pray." All right, and he went and he prayed, and the whole battalion of soldiers waited for him to pray, and then they went on the battlefield, and there was a good reason for that, because this man saved a lot of lives. All right, continue.
Figure this war is just going to fit in with your ideas?
While everybody else is taking life, be saving it. That's gonna be my way to serve.
This is a personal gift from the United States government designed to bring death to the enemy.
Oh, I'm sorry, Sergeant. I can't touch a gun.
You don't kill.
No, sir.
You know, quite a bit of killing does occur in war.
Private Doss does not believe in violence. Do not look to him to save you on the battlefield.
I don't think this is a question of religion. I think this is cowardice.
I fell in love with you because you weren't like anyone else. You're saying you could go to prison.
I don't know how I'm going to live with myself if I don't stay true to what I believe. With the world so set on tearing itself apart, it doesn't seem like such a bad thing to me to want to put a little bit of it back together.
Private Doss, you are free to run into the hellfire of battle without a single weapon to protect yourself.
This is a film that I recommend everyone to watch, because when I watched it, I was absolutely blown away, you know, because it was based upon a true story as well. All right. And this guy, Desmond Doss, his dad was an alcoholic, you know. His dad used to beat on him. And his dad was in the army as well. And this man... 100%, I mean, I could be wrong, we could be wrong, you know, but I guarantee you this man was an Israelite man, because the faith that he showed was tremendous. And basically he went into World War II and said, I will not pick up a rifle, all right, no guns for me, I'm just going to be a medical, you know, a medic to help heal people and patch them up. And he was bullied when he was doing his training, you know, by his fellow soldiers, really badly. They even locked him up, you know. They did everything possible to stop him from basically passing as a soldier and going to war. But it was the Lord's destiny for him to do all those things. And in the end, he saved 75 lives. And the way he did it was absolutely incredible. Remember, no guns, nothing. He had no weapons on him. He was just a medic, because, you know, he said that, listen, he promised God that he would never pick up a gun again, all right, because there was one time where his dad was beating the crap out of his mother, all right, and he got a gun in the house, you know, to put it to his dad's head and say, leave my mum alone, you know, and he felt guilty. So when you watch this film based on a true story, it actually mirrors what we're going to actually go through in Jacob's Trouble. We're going to have to have a countenance on us. The Lord's going to have to put a spirit on us of having faith that he's in control. Because the reality is, he is in control. And we have to remember, like the brother said in the video I just watched, which was an excellent video, that's why I'm doing this video, is that that judgment is for the wicked ones of our nation. All right, if you're in his truth and you're doing what you're supposed to do, all right, the Lord will take care of you, okay? Especially in you know, in that trying time that's coming. All right, so Matthew chapter 6 verse 31, therefore take no thought saying, what shall ye eat, or what shall ye drink, or wherewithal shall we be clothed. Alright, verse 32, for all these things do the Gentiles seek, which is material things, for your heavenly Father knoweth that ye have in need of all these things. So the Lord knows what our needs are, and he knows that in that time that is coming, that time of trouble, all right, he's gonna know what we need at certain times, and he's gonna provide it, okay, you know, and we're gonna be delivered, just like how Desmond Doss was delivered, all right. And that's why that Hacksaw Ridge is a film to watch. But it's a stipulation. For us to get that covering, that hedge of protection, we have to do something. All right? And it's here in the scripture, Matthew 6, verse 33. All right? But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. All right? And the Lord is a what? He's rebuilding the tabernacle of David of old. All right, he's raising up the tabernacle of David, which is his elect. All right, so to raise up a tabernacle, all right, and to have that tabernacle full, we have to have the full knowledge of Yahweh Bashim Yahshai. So when we learn things in this truth, all right, where we learn breakdowns, we learn history, etc., it's our job to put it in these videos that are palatable, especially for people that are new. It's very important that when we do the work of the Lord, we have to make it plain upon tables. We have to sometimes even repeat ourselves and explain certain words, phrases, and what we mean. Because a new person that God's woken up into this truth, all right, might watch a video like mine, and if I say Jake, you know, which is short for Jacob, which means us Israelites, he might not know. So I have to, you know, kind of explain that. It's very important to do that, man. And that's a part of seeking the kingdom of God, doing the work of Yahweh Bashim Yahshai. But also, it says what? Seek ye first the kingdom of God. So this can't be just some fucking side dish, you know? You know, like we have a meal, you know, you have a main meal, and then you might have a little pudding afterwards. No, 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 no. This truth is the main meal, all right? All right? Man shall not live by bread alone. We all know that scripture, okay? Because this word is feeding us, all right? It's feeding us. This word is like unto food, okay? So seek ye the kingdom of God and his righteousness, all right? Well, what is his righteousness? His laws, statutes, and commandments, you know? Applying them into your life to the best of the ability that the Lord has given unto you. All right? Learning them. All right? And then seeking his righteousness. If you don't know what his righteousness is, all right, then how can you implement it into your life? You know? That's where these videos also come into play. All right? And all these things shall be added unto you. All right? So if we do this, then when those wicked time comes, all right, the Lord will provide for us. Just like how he provided for Desmond Doss. Alright? Another good example is Elijah. Okay? So, yeah, fantastic. I mean, you know, who would think that God will command ravens to come feed Elijah? You know? That's incredible, man. Alright? So there's going miracles going to be happening in this trying time that's coming up, man. Alright? This is 1 Kings 17:4. Alright? And it shall be that thou shalt drink of the brooks, and I have commanded the ravens to feed thee there. All right? And who's he talking about? Talking about Elijah. Okay? So the Lord took care of Elijah. All right? All right, verse 5. So he went and did according to the word of the Lord, for he went and dwelt by the brook Cherith, that is before Jordan. Alright. Verse 6. And the ravens brought him bread and flesh in the morning. Alright. And bread and flesh in the evening. And he drank of the brook. So that while there was a famine going on in this time. Alright. Famine going on. People are starving. Lack of water. The Lord feeded Elijah. Why? Because Elijah did what? He seeked the kingdom of heaven first. All right? He seek the kingdom of heaven first. That's why the Lord took care of him. Okay? That's what he did. So when it comes to this great tribulation now, we're going to have the same mindset. Okay? No one is feeding them, what's it called, them Palestinians over there in the Gaza Strip. Okay? Alright? And everyone that's dying of malnutrition and famine over there, the Lord has ordained that. Alright? So just like this great tribulation that's coming, understand that the Lord, that's a judgment for the wicked, man. Alright? And when I say the wicked ones of these heathens and the wicked ones of our people, really, it's the start of the judgment of our people, man. Alright? And the Lord said, like in 1 Peter 4 and 17, the Lord said he's going to start with the house of God. Alright? People that know that they're Israelites. So once you've known you're Israelite, alright, what you do with that knowledge, it's up to you. Alright? If you don't, well, really, it's up to the Lord. Because he programs people. But at the end of the day, you don't take heed. Alright? You're going to be one of those sinners that are going to be dying by the sword. Like it says in Amos, man. Alright? And you're going to think in your mind that, oh, no, no, the blood of Jesus is covering me. Or Muhammad is looking after you, this, that, and the other. Blah, blah, blah. And, hey, depends what the Lord wants to do. He might make you starve to death. You know, he can do what he wants. Alright? So, this is an understanding that on a spiritual level, which is the highest level that you can understand, that this judgment coming is for the wicked ones of our people. Alright? So, yeah, we're going to be involved. We're going to be in the midst. We're going to see. We're going to experience bad things. But at the end of the day, alright, there's going to be salvation at the end of us showing that faith, just like Elijah did. Alright, relying on the Lord, man. Okay? And if you go back to Amos 9, verse 11, alright? Go to verse 11. It says, in that day I will raise up the tabernacle of David that is fallen, and close up the breaches thereof. And the breaches means all the differences. You know, like there's a scripture about Judah not vexing Ephraim. Because all of that business of northern kingdom, not like his southern kingdom, you know, this, that, and the other, Israelite tribes magnify himself, all that is going to be is being done away with. All right? Because we're seeing the tabernacle of David being raised up. That's why Yahweh says that the kingdom of heaven is in you. All right? It's in the elect, man. Okay? And I will raise up his ruins and build it in the days of old. And that's what is happening now. So if we seek the kingdom of heaven with all our heart and all our might, miracles are going to happen in these last days when all hell is breaking loose, just like it was for Desmond Doss, man. All right?
He was the conscientious objector who chose to fight in a way that would help people. He had the wild idea that he could serve his country at war and also obey the command, thou shalt not kill.
Yep.
No one imagined he could pull that off. Most of his comrades mocked and harassed him. His officers tried to get him discharged, thrown out of the army. But when the men of Company B assaulted Hacksaw Ridge on the island of Okinawa, something happened that would change their opinions forever. Medic Desmond Doss would be transformed from the most reviled to the most revered soldier, and would end up being the first conscientious objector in American history to win the Congressional Medal of Honor. You're never going to forget his incredible story.
And it is a very incredible story, man. You know? And the beautiful thing about it, it's a true story. And the true stories are always the best stories, man. And it's a bit here that I want to show.
Held to get them off this ridge. Desmond had about 12 hours of light to get them down. He began by dragging them to the edge. And there he remembered something that would greatly help. A bowline knot he'd learned to tie as a kid. Desmond realized he could make the double loop bigger and slip a man's arm through them. Wrapping one end of the long rope around a shattered tree stump, he could lower the man down the cliff to those waiting under cover below.
Yep.
So that's what he did, scurrying around this ridge, dodging a terrifying mixture of mortar and machine gun fire. One wounded man after another, taken to the ridge, lowered with a bowline. The men looking up could hardly believe what was happening.
Time after time, I saw dogs go back into the enemy, into the Japanese, and pick up wounded, and bring them there and let them down on these ropes and one thing another off of the escarpment. And the bullets were flying like bees or something. It was miraculous. I couldn't understand how he could do this.
Desmond kept praying, "Lord, please help me get one more." And he kept succeeding, even though when he had to stand up at the edge of the cliff to begin lowering each wounded man, the Japanese had a clear angle on his head and shoulders. Somehow, none of the bullets whizzing by caught this medic. Years later, in fact, one of those Japanese soldiers would actually recall that he had Desmond in his sights, but his gun jammed every time he pulled the trigger.
There you go. His gun jammed every time he pulled the trigger. Why was that? You know why? Because the Lord didn't want him to die. The Lord had a purpose for him. Alright? And that's why that film is called Hacksaw Ridge. Because it was a massive ridge. And the soldiers had to go up it to fight the Japanese. And they would get attacked so badly, they would have to run towards that ridge and go down again. Alright? And you know, because there's so many soldiers, many of them got shot, killed, etc. And this guy, Desmond Doss, actually got wounded, all right, as you saw in that clip, and got ropes and allowed them to basically, you know, to slowly level them down from the ridge so they can get further medical treatment. He saved 75 people. He even helped a Japanese soldier. It was definitely one. It could have been more. I don't know. All right. Who was wounded as well. You know, he did not discriminate. So this is amazing stuff. But you saw in this clip just now that a Japanese soldier said, "I had him in my sights, and every time I went to shoot the gun jammed." Why is that? All right. Because the Lord had a hedge of protection around him. Okay. Basically, he was exempt from judgment, because the Lord said that there'll be three world wars. All right, that's in Revelations 11 and 14, and Revelations 9 and 12, Isaiah 9 and 5, yeah, you know, etc. And well, wars are judgment for the people, man. All right, the wickedness that they've been doing is judgment. It's not a blessing; it's a curse. All right. But some people are exempt from that judgment. And he was. And that's what we want. All right. When this great tribulation happens. Okay. So this is Isaiah chapter 9 verse 4. "And the Lord said unto them, go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem." And Jerusalem is us. It's a people more than it's a place. Us Israelites, man. "And set a mark upon the foreheads of the men." Notice he says men, man. Alright. The Lord is dealing with men. Okay. The Lord is dealing with men. Not your Christianity having women. You know, women as pastors and all this madness, man. Alright. "Upon their foreheads of the men that sigh and that cry for the abominations that are done in the midst thereof." Alright. And abominations are filthy acts. And I'm telling you, every time I put on the TV, I sigh and I cry. Every time I see a man dressed as a woman. Any time, just a few hours ago, there was a UFC thing on TV. And this guy, Sean O'Malley, he has a woman, and she's a, I think she's an Issacharite woman, or she's one of the Latin tribes, anyway, one of the Northern Kingdom. And, you know, on the day of his fight, she dressed, and you should have seen what, and she's married to this guy. She's got a child of him, or I think two children, I think, two, no, one child. And she, you know, she went to travel, you know, to the Las Vegas stadium where he was going to fight. And you should have seen the way she was dressed, you know. Her skirt was so short that it basically looked like her top. She was like naked from the waist down, you know. And when I saw that, it got me angry. That's the kind of abominations that we are sighing and crying about every day. Seeing a man dressed as a woman, you know, all the wickedness that is going on. All right, you niggas killing each other over nothing. All right, Israelites sticking up for master. All of these things are an abomination. Yeah? So the men of the Lord, the elect, they're going to be sighing and crying about these abominations. But that's a sign that they are exempt from judgment, man. All right. And it says that he continued, verse 5. And to the others in my hearing, go ye after him through the city and smite. Let not your eyes spare, neither have pity. All right. Death angels, man. All right. Judgment of the Lord. Verse 6, slay utterly old and young, both maids and little children, little boys, little girls, man, and women, but not near any man upon whom is the mark, and begin at my sanctuary, alright, but it says what, but come not near any man upon whom is the mark. All right, now let's look up the word mark here. All right, and it would be the Hebrew word fawa, man. All right.
Strong's age 84.
Which means what?
Tav.
Right.
Tav.
Which means what? It means to be what? Mark, a sign of exemption from judgment, a sign of exemption from judgment, just like Desmond Doss. Death was all around him, you know, all around him, man. We're talking about one of the worst wars, the biggest war. How many people died in World War II? Over 60 million. All right, how many people were injured? In its millions, people were hideously deformed. All right, because of the bombing, amputations everywhere, medical supplies were low. Some people were amputated with no anesthetic, just like what's happening in the Gaza Strip. All right, that's what was happening. But through all of that, Desmond Doss, yes, he got a few injuries, but they were minor ones. But he was what? Exempt from judgment, because the Lord put that mark upon him. All right, just like with the Passover. You know, when our ancestors had to put the blood, you know, on, you know, like the blood on the posts of the door, you know, and then that death angel came, all right, and it went passed over us, and it got the ancient Egyptians and killed them, man. Okay. All of that death passed over our people and got our enemies, you see? So that is a sign of being exempt from judgment, and that's what we're gonna need. But there's a stipulation. We have to seek the Lord and thy God with all our heart and all our soul, and put the kingdom of heaven first. All right, that's the deal. That's the contract, man. Okay, that's the contract. And we've been the reason why we're in this mess, because we keep breaking contracts with the Heavenly Father, you know? Which is not a God that, he's the only God, and it's not a God you want to play with, man. I mean, the way the Lord has spanked us as a people, we are unrecognizable. You know, when to the, you know, to the point now where if you tell people, listen, St. George was one of our people, a black man, an Israelite, they'll just laugh at you, man, until you show them the pictures. Shakespeare, Mozart, you know, the five good Roman emperors, which they all were Jakes. You say that, the average person, even an average black person, they would just laugh about that. You know why? Because we're so low in society, they're thinking you niggas couldn't have been these great people. You see? But that's a part of us breaking the law's contract. So in this time, all right, if we do that and you know, do our obligations towards the Lord, all right, by following him, seeking his office, all right, seeking his righteousness, all right, then the Lord will deliver us. Okay, just like he did Desmond Doss. All right, just Job 5, verse 19. And he shall deliver thee in six troubles. Yea, in seven there shall no evil touch thee. And seven is a metaphor for completion. All right. In famine he shall redeem thee from death. Okay, just like with Elijah. The Lord sent ravens, you know, to feed him. All right, and in war from the power of the sword. Okay, unlike the sinners of our people, they're going to die by the sword. Verse 21, thou shalt be hid from the scourge of the tongue, neither shalt thou be afraid of the destruction when it cometh. All right, so the Lord's going to put us a spirit on us. When this first happens, you know, you know, you might forget yourself and be panicking, your heart's going to be beating, you know. But the Lord is going to, all of those scriptures and the words of the Heavenly Father is just going to come onto us. And we're going to remember who we are and remember the God that we serve, all right. And once we do that, we're going to say, hang on, you know what? The Lord is with me, okay. So at the end of the day, that if the Lord is with me, you know, things are going to be okay, man. The Lord will provide. All right? That's where our faith is going to have to kick in. Our faith is going to be extremely tested. All right? So verse 22, at destruction and famine, thou shalt laugh, neither shalt thou be afraid of the beasts of the earth. Because another way the Lord can destroy you is by putting the spirit on beasts, you know, to come out. I mean, look at the alligators. You know, what happened in our history. This devil feeding black babies to alligators. You know, even the Arabs, as wicked as them Arabs are, and they're wicked, man, and they hate our people. As wicked as them Arabs are, they wouldn't even do that, man. You know, this devil done that. Okay. All right, verse 23. For thou shalt be in league with the stones of the field, and the beasts of the field shall be at peace with thee. All right. Because in that day, boy, man, the Lord might just open up Zeus, all right? Or people might do it. Either way, the Lord's doing it because he controls people, all right? And all these wild creatures might be roaming the streets of London, man, you know? And you see, you know, a pack of lions, you know, charging at you. They might charge at you, and there you are shitting your pants. And then when they, you know, when they jump on you, they just lick your face. Alright? Did not Daniel be thrown into a lion's den? So, you know? Those lions were not activated to rip him apart because it wasn't his time for it, you know, it wasn't the Lord's will to give him that judgment. Okay? If that was the average evil, wicked nigger, them lions would have been, woo! You know, they were like, rah! You know, they would have ripped him. They would rip him apart, man. They would have, ah! You know? But it was the man of the Lord. The lions didn't touch him. Okay? So that's the mindset we're going to have in these last days, man. Because believe me, shit is going to pop off. Wow, the stuff that's going to be popping off. You know? You ain't seen nothing yet, man. You know? Nothing yet. Alright, verse 24. And thou shalt know that thy tabernacle shall be in peace. And thou shalt thou shalt visit thy habitation and shall not sin. All right. So in these these times that are coming off, that are coming up, all right, just understand and know that this judgment that is coming, all right, this great tribulation, okay, that is coming, understand and know that yes, it's gonna be one of the worst times ever on earth, all right, but if we do what we're supposed to do, all right, if we do what we're supposed to do, we do what the Lord has commanded of us, all right, if we do that, if we give diligence to make our calling and our election sure, then hey, you know, then what's gonna happen? All right, these bad times are gonna happen. All right, these prophecies are gonna kick off, the great tribulation. People around the world are gonna be shooting and killing each other. But just like Desmond Doss, all right, miracles are gonna happen. Guns will jam. All right, you know, an angel might, you know, basically teleport you from one place to another. You're in one place, then the Lord puts you in a place of safety. You know, when this tribulation, Jeremiah 30 verse 7, all right, Jacob's trouble happens, all right, the main people, and why is it called Jacob's trouble? It's because mainly the elites know who we are and they want to get rid of us. They have a plan to basically try and exterminate us, all right, as a nation. And basically, because everything has been normal, they've been doing it behind closed doors. But when everything is in utter total chaos and all around the world, all right, they're going to be doing it openly, man. All right. Everyone's going to feel it, but we're going to feel it much more. Okay. So this is the time to really be locked in to this truth. And when I say that, I say myself, you know, first and foremost, man. All right. Like that scripture on the screen, 2 Ezra 16:71. They'll be like madmen sparing none. Alright? Sparing none. But the elect of nation Israel, they will be spared. They will be preserved, man. Okay? So listen, man. Make sure you try and look at the film. Hacksaw Ridge. Excellent. You know, it's one of the best army films I've ever seen, man. You know? So, on to the next one. I pray you were edified. Shalom.